What's going on, you guys? Welcome back to another little video. And today, two fucking day, as you guys can probably tell, we're gonna be installing the transmission back on that piece of shit. I just got the transmission about 2 days ago, and yesterday I got my torque converter. It's chilling right there. Have it, you know, filling it up with some transmission fluid, letting it pretty much get not full, but I'm just adding some in there. You know, that shit takes about 5 quarts of oil. Letting it fill up, and then right now I'm just waiting on my dad so he can help me bring down the transmission so we can finally get it going on this shit. It's been down for almost a month. About 3 weeks now, maybe. I think. I don't know. It just feels like a long time that I haven't driven this piece of shit, so I really need to get back on the road. But anyways, hopefully I can get it done today. I will get it done today. After that, I have to head down to the exhaust shop and get the exhaust welded back on. After that, I have to see if I can make a stop at this local car stereo place so they can check out my alarm, because it's acting all kinds of weird. Like, if I hit the shit out of it, it won't even fucking, the alarm won't go off anymore, and that's fucking annoying. So I'm gonna take it, sorry about the wind, guys, a little bit windy, but take it down to them, see if they can fix it, and then after that, then it'll be good. I'll probably take it to my boy so he can wash it. It's fucking dirty, like it's dirty. You probably can't tell that much in video, but we'll see what happens. And then I'm gonna try to make this video the best that I can. Once again, I am gonna be alone. If anything, my dad's just gonna help me get the transmission up so I can just at least bolt it on to the block of the engine, and then after that, then I'm probably just gonna be on my own. So I will try to make the best video that I can. I don't make any promises. You know, I'm trying to get this thing done pretty quick. But like I said, I'll try to make the best video that I can. So yeah. So right now I'm just adding some more ATF. This is still my old torque converter. The guy said it was good. He said he didn't see any metal come out. He didn't see any metal shavings. He supposedly said that he fully drained it. So we'll see how it goes. Hopefully it is good. He said it was. He said that he didn't see any metal shavings whenever he drained it into a pan. So he said it's still good. So yeah. Oh, and then the thing that happened with my transmission, the thing that went out, was the fucking band that I guess hugs the drum. He said that it got overheated, got stuck, and I guess that might have prevented the pump from turning or something. But he said he upgraded it to a Kevlar band, and he replaced a few other parts. He didn't tell me what parts, but hopefully it runs good and I don't have any more problems. But yeah, I'm just gonna keep letting this thing fill up. See, it's already going down, and then I'm just waiting on my dad. He's actually working right now. I took the day off to do this. So just waiting on him. And then after that, I'll get to installing it and get this bitch back on the road. Damn, guys. My fucking bad. I seriously forgot to press record. And the fucking camera, so I was talking and recording, and this bitch wasn't even recording. Well, I mean, I was like over here trying to make a video, and this bitch wasn't even recording. But anyways, ooh, that was a fucking bitch. Transmission is installed. Got the torque converter installed. So now all that's left is I'm gonna install the torque converter bolts that go to the flywheel. Pretty much hard to record this whole time, but I got the cross member on some of the exhaust. I'm gonna have to go so I can, you know, weld that shit back on there. Have to see if I can find either a new nut or just get the new nut and bolt for this, because the other one I don't know where it is. I have to get a new one for that. But I might just tell them to re-weld it on. Yeah. I'll come back here in a little bit. Okay, so I got this part, the exhaust done. Still need to put the transmission mount bolt on, but pretty much everything is done. Need to tighten up these cross member bolts. Need to put the shifter link, drive shaft, and we're almost good to go. Has it been a bitch to, you know, record and try to do a good little video at the same time, but I try my best, you know, try my best to put good videos out for you guys. But I mean, it's a bitch, you know. If I had a badass little shop and a lift and everything, man, you know, everything would be so fucking easy. But shit, where the fuck are you going? It's just a bitch to record and you know, work at the same time, because this shit gets pretty fucking frustrating. Like, real talk, this shit gets fucking frustrating. And now I don't remember how this goes. Like that, I guess. Then this bitch goes like a lot. Oh fuck. Anyways, I'm just gonna sit you guys down again and record some more. You know, so this video is mainly gonna be time lapsing, but basically to take off a transmission, you have 7 bolts, or like 9. It's 1, 2, and then on the opposite side, it's the same 1, 2, other side, and then 1 at the very top. You know, it's just frustrating to get to all these bolts, then having to be on the fucking ground. You know, it's annoying, but you can get it done. But anyways, gonna put you guys down again and put you guys in a time lapse again. So sorry if I'm not doing much talking. But yeah, boy. I'm not afraid to die. Well, I pretty much think that I have everything installed. Got the drive shaft installed, all the oil lines, all the electrical connections that go to that bitch. I think literally all that's left is just to all that's left is just to bring this hoe down, top it off, check for any leaks, and see what it does. Alright guys, well, I need both hands for this, so I'll come back whenever I have the truck on the ground. Okay, it's on the ground. So now, moment of truth. All right, let me see if I can set you guys right here. Okay. And I'm so happy about this little tripod. Anyways, let's fill it up with fluid. Fluid. Put some fluid. You gotta master the pour technique. You see that? The only thing that sucks about this, takes forever to put fucking ATF fluid in this bitch because for how small the hole is. Get at it. Extra fucking slow. Guys, well, I have bad news. Unfortunately, this transmission, is not good anymore. Very disappointed. You know, I waited almost 3 weeks, maybe a month, you know, to get this transmission back, and I, you know, I was expecting it to come back strong and, you know, no problems with it whatsoever. But unfortunately, it's just not working right. You know, it's slipping really bad. You know, if I try to get on it a little bit, you know, it's just not what it's supposed to be. You know, it's not how it used to be. I got in contact with the guy who rebuilt it. He keeps telling me that I didn't top it off to the correct level, which I know for damn sure I did. You know, I checked that fucking, the fucking thing, well, I forgot what that shit's called. I checked the dipstick over and over, and it, you know, it's where it's supposed to be. Look, and it does it worse on, you know, from a dead stop. Watch this. It's just not what it's supposed to be, you know, and it's very frustrating. Like I said, you know, he kept telling me that it's either I didn't top it off right, it's either too much fluid or not enough fluid, which is pretty, you know, in my opinion, it's pretty stupid because, you know, like, how are you going to tell me that? I'm looking at the fucking dipstick and I'm seeing that it's literally right where it's supposed to be. It's at the perfect level. He kept telling me that to check the codes, check the check engine. There's no check engine light. So what am I going to scan it for if there's no light? He kept telling me that it's tune related. That's not tune related. You know, I highly doubt that the transmission slipping, it's because of a fucking tune. And either way, you know, when I got it tuned, man, this thing was fucking running like a dream. You know, it was running perfect. He also kept telling me if all of those are not it, then it's you know, driver error. How the fuck? Like, you know, bro, like, I guess it is what it is. You know, it's a lesson learned. You know, like I said, the reason why I went to this guy is because some people recommended me to him. He seemed promising. He seemed like he knew what he was doing. And, you know, I give him props. This fucking thing held up, you know, held up for about a year, almost a year. And now it's not even, you know, I mean, I'm kind of lost for words, bro. I'm just so frustrated. See what I'm talking about? You know, and it's like, I don't know, man. Like, he keeps telling me to take it back to him, but I don't think I'm gonna take it back, to be honest with you guys. I'm just gonna take it somewhere else. You know, this is pretty dumb, having to go through all of this shit, you know, and to have a transmission not even work the way it's supposed to work when you've had it for about 3 weeks. You know, you had plenty of time to look at that transmission and see what exactly was wrong with it, but it's, I don't know, man. You know, unfortunately, it is what it is. This is not, it's not working, you know. It's just not. Watch when it shifts. It shifts, then it bogs out, goes back to first, shifts into second, and then after it shifts into second, it's like so sluggish, you know. It's not right. So I mean, like I said, it's a lesson learned. Definitely won't be going back to him. So, you know, I'm just gonna end the video off here, you guys. Sorry if I didn't record what I, you know, as much as I wanted to. Oh, this is, I'm just pissed, man. So, if anything, I'll be coming back with another video of maybe when I take it somewhere else. I already have an idea where I'm gonna take it, and you know, the guy is just, they seem more professional. In my opinion, you know, he doesn't just sell you the transmission. He sells you the transmission, but he wants to install it himself, you know, because that's part of his warranty. That way, you know, he tests it out and makes sure that the bitch is running good. So, like I said, I already have an idea of where I'm going to take it, and I'm just going to go from there, you know. So, it is what it is. It's a lesson learned, and I'll catch you guys in the next video.